Well, welcome to Grow With Angie. I'm Angie, and I want to talk to you about letting your hydroponics rest, taking a break from your harvest, and what all of that entails. If you've seen any of my other videos, I talk about having a bug problem or an aphid issue. I believe this really started from last year when I bought my first unit and brought in outdoor plants from my deck and introduced them to my hydroponic systems. I slowly started seeing aphids develop on all of my plants, and I have done absolutely everything I could think of to get rid of the bugs. What was the process to take these iHarvest into rest? First, I trimmed back all of my kale and took all of the leaves over to the sink and soaked them for about 2 hours, making sure all of the aphids were killed and floated off the leaves. That way I could still use that harvest. Roots on the kale had gotten very large and they were very healthy plants. So sad to say, the underneath of the plant was doing very, very well, but the leaves were really struggling with the bug issue. Behind my unit, everything looked really good. I didn't have any water drippage, no damage to my wall, and I was very happy with the outcome of pulling it away from the wall. Now, as a precaution for myself, I use packing tape and put it on the bottom level. This is not necessary, but it was just something that made me feel comfortable doing. And you can see it also was collecting bugs almost like a fly tape. After I had removed all of the plants and detached it from the wall, I started to take the unit apart. I took each level into the bathroom and washed it in the bathtub with dish soap and a scrubber. It did take a little bit of elbow grease, but I removed the algae. Now, the unit on your left is one that I have had up for over a year. The algae was starting to build up, but it could have been much worse if I wasn't using my beloved reflective covers that I recommend everyone use. They easily lay over top of your net cup, over your plant, and they just rest there. They don't stick. There's no secret to them. They just lay in place. It also reflects the light to the base of your plant, giving your plant more of a 360 of light. But because the back is black, it will stop any algae buildup on your growing media. I believe that was a huge benefit in slowing the algae in my unit. But because there was more than I liked, I ended up pulling it apart and scrubbing it clean. I drained the tank with my pool sump pump and put the units back together. This way the unit can sit and dry and we will make sure all the bugs are gone. Now on the right unit, this is my newer one, which I purchased just 6 months ago. The inside still looked really well and there was not an algae problem at all. This one I had beautiful green onions, which got much bigger and larger than I had ever expected. Those I cut and chopped up to use for recipes throughout the next week. The basil I pulled out and made basil butter, and the rest of the herbs I dried on my drying rack, including my dill and my parsley. My alfalfa was an experiment and it got crazy big. We used it as much as we could for green shakes, but the rest of it went out to the chickens and they enjoyed it too. Once that unit was clear of all plants, I used a hydrogen peroxide and water mix and I sprayed the outside, scrubbing it down and cleaning it up as much as I could. Because the inside looked good, I wasn't going to worry about that at this point. I also drained that tank and made sure that they are going to both sit nice and dry. I'll probably let them sit throughout the holidays, and it's kind of sad when company comes over and you have these empty units and nothing to show for your growing, but it also feels like a fresh new start going into the winter to start all over again. And I know this time I am 100% bug free. Something else that you can do, it's called mosquito bits, and you can make little bags of these and hang them in your water reservoir. What this will do is kill any larvae that might be growing in the water. But because I had aphids and white flies, those reproduce on the leaves themselves and do not leave any larvae in the water. So just letting my units dry and rest was the best decision for me. And I'm not gonna ask you to hit that like button. I would rather hear comments below. If you have any suggestions on how I can be better or I can give more information to you, please let me know. It helps me give more content back to you. But please hit that subscribe button so I know you're there watching, and it just encourages me to keep going and making these videos. If you're letting your unit rest with me, which some of you are on the Facebook group, let me know when you start planting again and we will grow together.